Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and I'm going to address Burr Amendment Number 2, and I will withdraw it. Let me say to my colleagues, the ABLE Act, I think when we passed it, was the most significant legislation to affect those with disabilities in this country since the ADA, and Senator Casey was a tremendous partner. And its passage meant that we allowed states to create 529 accounts for anybody that had disabilities before the age of 26. Mr. Chairman, this took 8 years to accomplish, 8 long years, but we finally got across the goal line. The one mistake that we made, if there was one, was that we left in place a residency requirement. Now, what's that mean? If you compare an ABLE 529 to a college 529 that doesn't have a residency act, it means that you can establish that 529 account in any state. We don't have that capability, and this has already been recognized by entities like the Department of Treasury, where the Department of Treasury has attempted to address the residency issue in its recent notice of proposed rulemaking, where it provides that an ABLE account beneficiary, upon moving to a different state, will have the option to either maintain an ABLE account created in that prior state, or to close the account and open a new ABLE account if, in fact, that state has ABLE accounts within the state. So I share that with you to display. There is a problem, and agencies are beginning to handle this. What would solve it? It's real easy. If we did away with the residency requirement and we allowed the 529s for individuals with disabilities to reflect exactly the same structure that we do for educational 529s. And if I could just read just briefly a letter that Senator Casey and I received from most, if not all, of the organizations and associations and corporations which span the disability community, financial sector, state agencies, and other entities preparing for ABLE administration. And they say, we want to offer our strong and overwhelming support for the elimination, to eliminate the 529A state residency requirement found in the ABLE Act. The legislation change would make 529 program consistent with the traditional 529 programs. And it goes on to say, the door has already been opened to this amendment by existing language in the Federal ABLE Act, which allows states to contract with each other. Additionally, what I stated about the Department of Treasury and their most recent determination about the transferability of an ABLE account or the existence of an ABLE account in a state that you left and your residency is somewhere else. So I say to my colleagues, this is a really, really important technical change that I hope we will find the will to do. I realize this vehicle may not be the germane way to do it, but I would ask the chair, the ranking member, and staffs to work with us as we find the way to handle this most basic technical change.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.